of regret versus guilt. Guilt is somehow something much deeper. And then the really tragic second, notice we have two exemplars from actual war. The second one, deeply disturbing, of course, this is the Joseph Mayock example of the young private who, because of something that had nothing to do with him, he ends up being shot in the face and ultimately dying. And Captain John Pryor, who is the one who will say, "I had feelings of responsibility." Now, he says it. I wasn't obviously egregiously responsible. In other words, it wasn't something, he calls it a comedy of errors, to quote a famous Shakespeare play. He says, "There's, however, not a day that goes by that I don't think about it, at least to some degree." We have the definition of guilt, finally, by paragraph 13. What Pryor feels are feelings of guilt, and not simply regret that things didn't work out differently. He feels, and this is, you're going to want to underline this because this is a powerful definition Sherman's giving us. He feels the awful weight of self-indictment, that notion of disapproval toward oneself. Self-blame, our footnote will in fact tell us, right? The empathy with the victim and survivors and the need to make moral repair. Think about how that works in terms of Seventh Man and why it is that finally he decides after 40 years to return back to the scene of the accident. And moral repair, right? If he didn't feel that, we would say about Captain Pryor, we would probably think less of him as a commander. Then we have this amazing story in paragraph 14 of how Mayock's mother is able to overcome her sense of loss by working through that sense of loss through writing, sending information, the letters and that type of thing, which is just compelling. Notice she as well is dealing maybe with a sense of loss and possibly survivor's guilt as well. In other words, this essay suggests that we all have to kind of deal with that in very powerful and different ways. By paragraph 15, we're talking about redemptive guilt and the idea, while sounding a little bit, she says, too moralistic, it does make the sense that maybe that war and the loss of soldiers in war has some kind of powerful evolutionary adaptive, she will call it, in the way that fear is. But even there, she says, there's something not quite right evaluative about this because, she says, good soldiers depend on each other, come to love each other, have duties to care and bring each other safely home. She finishes with Kant's imperfect duties. Even in the best of circumstances, we can't perfectly fulfill them. And she finishes by saying that what duties to others need to make room for, even in a soldier's life of service and sacrifice, are duties to self or self-forgiveness and self-empathy. These are a part of full moral repair. I would circle that term, moral repair. And this is the reason that we love the classic stories. As we say, we are the stories we tell and retell, the stories we accept, and of course we're the stories we reject, as we've said often in 303. But think about the powerful ending of the Iliad and the ways in which Achilles has to come to terms with the fact that the father, Priam, who is asking for the body of Hector back, is very similar to Achilles says his own father and the ways in which his dad would want his body back so that he can properly bury it. That notion of empathy, of seeing the other, is a powerful moment as well. Well, let's go ahead and quickly now at 2A. What does this text suggest for us in terms of messages? Well, one obvious message that we can write down is that survivor guilt is something that one has to really, really grapple and wrestle with. It is not easy to deal with those feelings of guilt and how to understand those feelings of guilt, both for the individual who's engaged in the guilt, as well as others who are kind of looking on and trying to understand as well. Notice at 2A we can write down for our rhetoric observation that we have lots and lots of what we call in 303 external validation. We're quoting, we're going and finding validation outside of our own opinions. And notice the compelling way in which Sherman will use those quotes to try to make her editorial more powerful. At 3A, we've already mentioned the Iliad. Obviously, we've mentioned the Seventh Man. What are some other movies or stories or video games, any number of texts that you are familiar with where survivor guilt plays a powerful role? Long ago, there was a famous film called Titanic that plays the same game. And finally, at three, what's a time in your life that you had to deal with feelings of the kind of guilt that's being described here? It wasn't your responsibility, yet you somehow felt a sense of guilt. And how did you deal with that moving forward? Well, let's go ahead and enjoy another text that will maybe play around with similar kinds of subjects. Thank you.